Now to a report from the Herald Sun's Michael Warner on Sports Integrity Australia, warning that the AFL and other Australian sports need to take urgent action to combat illicit drug use by their athletes. This week they recommended an immediate overhaul of the AFL's illicit drug policy, which allows players to avoid drug strikes and undergo off-the-books testing under what they call a medical model. The Chief of Sport of Integrity Australia, David Sharp, said significant intervention is required immediately to address the illicit drug culture in sport and the increasing and unacceptable risks posed to players, officials, clubs and sporting codes. Sport Integrity Australia, along with several partner organisations, have identified evidence across Australian sports of clear dangers of criminals influencing sports through the supply of illicit drugs, including by preying on athletes or support staff to access inside information. I mean, this is important because we've got gambling, it's enormous sports gambling, you've got the criminal world, and the manner in which players are accessing these drugs, you could see players, officials being blackmailed to provide information, to behave in a corrupt manner. And I wonder if the sporting codes are really treating this as seriously as they should.
I think Mr. Sharp makes a very good point there. I mean, look, I like a bet. Lots of us do. You can bet on the first ball of a cricket match being a no ball, or the first serve of a tennis match being a fault. Now, if you have players who are, you know, potentially leveraged by nefarious elements, I mean, it's not a big step to imagine that that sort of thing and that sort of, you know, corruption of the sport could happen pretty readily, and certainly off camera as well. I think it's a very good point, and I think it's something that we need to look at very closely.
Absolutely, and the AFL in particular, with that ridiculous drug policy, which is really designed to make sure no player ever gets three strikes.
And well, the players have been gaming it for years and years, haven't they, obviously?
The loopholes are deliberate. They're not accidental in that code. They've got to acknowledge the obvious there. Patrick Carlyle, thank you so much for your time this evening.
Thanks, Rita.